Hi, welcome to ToddFun.com, where I do what I think is fun, and today it's a product review. I got some Pomona test lead cable holders, test lead holders. Got two styles, this kind of orangish colored one, which has 15 slots, and then this black one, which actually has 8 slots, but it would be 10 if it wasn't a magnetic version. And so I'm going to cover how nicely these work to organize your cables. Like right now, I have all my oscilloscope probes, cables, and everything back here. My programming cables here. Over here, I have test leads and patch cables and jumpers. And it's a mess. And pegboard is no place to keep all that stuff. But up until now, that's all I've had. I guess I should have made something by now. But I don't know. I was getting by with this, and I was okay. And of course, you have to buy the stuff if you don't make it. But a company called Farnell's contacted me, said, well, they like my blog and they'd like me to pick some products for my lab, review them, no strings attached, just whatever I think. So I'll do that. I figured that's great. I'll get some stuff for my lab. And I picked out, for starters, I picked out a couple of these. I really probably just wanted these, but because it wasn't costing me anything, I figured I'd check out these more high expensive ones, these magnetic mount ones, because I do have a garage door over here that is metal, and this does stick to that. So I thought this would be a really great option. I could, over by the oscilloscopes, just pop this right on the garage door. Not going to work out so good, mostly because these magnets aren't very strong on this version. This is the Pomona 4408M, M for magnetic. And it's just some stick-on magnets that, you know, even though I have a lot of things magnetically stuck to my door now, these magnets just aren't enough. They just don't have enough power to them, I guess. They're more like thick fridge magnets, really. And they're just stuck on with it's double sticky tape on the one side. And then another thing I don't like about it is, like I say, 8 prongs instead of 10. They basically just bend down one of these prongs, and then they use it sort of like a brace. So I'm certainly not too terribly happy about that. They didn't quite bend them enough. I don't know if that shows up on camera, but they're a little sprung forward still. So you'd have to bend them even more for them to work well anyway. These are in millimeters. They are 8.13 millimeters. They're really good for larger objects like the back ends of your oscilloscope probes and stuff are thicker, so that gives you more space between those things that hang in here, so they don't like start crowding. If you have a smaller one, which I think is 5.33 millimeters in metric, and there's 15 of them there, but your oscilloscope probes, they get kind of crowded there. Anything with large attachments on the ends would get crowded, but they're really going to make a big difference. So this is the before photo of all my stuff on the wall, and then I'll have one at the end of how nicely this helps me organize. Some things that I probably should have considered is, I didn't know these were so short. They're not really that wide. So I got a lot of cables, so technically I'll probably need one more of these. This one will work fine for my oscilloscope probes and maybe a couple of my programming cables, because they're wider and thicker and I don't have that many. But I'm definitely going to be unbending these prongs, so it's just not worth $32 to $35 for this version. Whereas you can get this one for, I think it's like $17, which is a reasonable price. I've seen it cheaper though at other places. And then I don't really care for, I actually like this style. This is the 4408. Like I said, yes, I'll unbend these because I want the 10 slots. And then the way I see it, if you want a magnetic option, rather than spending the extra money for this coming with magnetic options, not to mention only this spacing comes with magnetic option, I'm not sure why. If you can have any of them be magnetic by making your own magnetic mount if you want to, or what I have is I have these magnetic bars that I get at the home store or hardware store. They're extremely powerful. They'll hold any number of heavy tools, and of course they're more than good enough for holding these test lead holders up. And you could put this anywhere you want. You could even screw it on something if you have something that's not magnetic. But if it is like some sort of a metal cabinet or something, this will pop on real good. And then if you wanted to have a magnetic option for your holders, this you could probably get two across here, just bam, just like that. You get that on, that isn't going to come off for nothing, and you don't lose any prongs that way. So this is a great option for this, and these only cost like maybe $8 to $10. Now for a bit about the company that contacted me and let me essentially order these. Farnell's, they're a really big company. They have almost 500,000 products they sell, including chips and anything in the electronics industry, really. It's an amazing amount of selection in their inventory. Now that Europeans, they're in Europe, they're called Farnell's. In Asia, they're called Element 14. In America, we call them Newark. But I would recommend just going to newark.com for just ordering stuff. But if you go to element14.com, then you got kind of a community site, and then there is a menu tab where you could click on the store, select your region, whatever region you are in the world, and then you'll go to whatever region actually distributes to you. In my case, it's Newark. Now the Newark site has, it's really well done as far as buying products, especially electronics, whether it be the components or batteries, chemicals, dispensing bottles, you name it, cabling, tools, oscilloscopes, everything. And they got two different types of ways of finding the stuff on their site, which I like. I like the fact that they have a parametric search for all this kind of stuff. But I advise you not to try and use their straight up simple search, because even though you will drill into some things, you won't find much. I was looking for these chemical dispensing bottles on their site, and I tried the simple search and I found some, but I knew their selection had to be huge because I was familiar with their catalog. And so by using the advanced search, it was easy to find the complete selection of these. And then they have an online catalog, so it's like flipping through a catalog, and it's interactive, meaning you, if you hover over top of products, you'll see more details about them and how much is in inventory. Really nice and easy to find. So there's a good plug for them there. Here's some negatives though. If you're on the online catalog, it says, like, you can go and you can look up Arduino, and it says, hey, you got 8 of them. Online catalogs, interactive environment will tell you that, but then when you actually click through the catalog back to the Newark product page to purchase it, you find out that they don't have any. So that's really not good that the two don't agree. But when you're when you are on their actual product pages, they have links to their data sheets. They have extra links to the products, and you can link from one to the other. You can go from their online catalog to their online products page with the parametric searching. So really well done there. Here's another negative. I used IE9, Internet Explorer 9, and some of the parametric searching wouldn't work. I'd get blank pages, literally just, you know, select from this page and blank. So I had to use, pretty much for all of their online tools, I had to use Firefox. And it worked fine in Firefox, so, you know, I know that's probably IE's problem, but still, you know, you got to keep current, because people are staying current and you got to keep current, so you need to look into that. Okay, I got all of my cables and test leads and oscilloscope probes all down, and I got them over on the garage door, so let's take a look. Okay, there they all are. I put a piece of quarter inch strap steel across the garage door and bolted it at either end. That went up pretty easy. I could have used the magnet bar like I used for my tools here for the Pomona test lead holders, but I went ahead and just put up some screws that are easy to come on and off in case I have to open the garage door. And just a quick scan of what it looks like up close. There we have oscilloscopes, digital multimeters, patch cables, jumpers. Yeah. Well, thanks for joining, and if you have a lot of test cables like I have and they're just a big mess like that, get some of those Pomona holders, and it'll clean up your lab really nicely. Get several, especially those ones with the 15, held 15 slots, because you really just fill them right up. And if you have more of them, then you'll be able to keep those different types of patch cables and jumpers and test leads all separate. So, thanks for joining.